everyone, welcome to Sourcing Classes. This is Hima Hegde presenting before you a video series on the topic Climatic Regions Around the World. This is the fourth part of the video series. The climatic region under focus in today's session is going to be the temperate continental region. Let us begin with the distribution. The temperate continental climate comes under the influence of westerlies. In other words, it lies in the westerly wind belt. It occurs in the temperate climate, that is in between the tropics, that is the equatorial region, and the frigid zone, that is the polar region. It is very remote or isolated from the maritime influence, and it is mostly a grassland, and there are in between 0 to no trees. On the right hand side, there is a map of the world depicting the distribution of the temperate continental climatic region. This region goes by different names in different places. In Eurasia and the Central Asia, it goes by the name steppe climatic region. In North America, it is called as the prairies. In South America, that is mostly Argentina and Uruguay, it is called as the pampas. In Australia, it goes by the name downs, whereas in South Africa, it is called as the veld. Let us now look at the climatic conditions. Coming to the temperature, we have already discussed that this region is isolated from the maritime influence. That is because it lies in the heart of the continent. That is, it is very distant from even the nearest sea. As a result, it experiences the continental temperature, which is extreme in most of the cases. The summers are very warm and the winters are extremely cold. Precipitation. The precipitation is not that high. It ranges between 10 to 30 inches every year. The annual precipitation in southern hemisphere is higher when compared to that in the northern hemisphere. This is because of the influence of the warm currents. Coming to the natural vegetation, the temperate continental climatic region is entirely covered with grass. Unlike the grass in the savanna region, the grass in the continental climatic region is very nutritious. In the areas where the rainfall is moderate or good, like in that of prairies, the grass is tall, fresh and nutritious. Whereas in steppe, where the rainfall is quite scanty, the trees are very scarce. Let us now look at the economy. Extensive cultivation is practiced in the temperate continental climatic region. Presently, most of the temperate grasslands have been converted into agricultural lands. In extensive cultivation, the area under cultivation is quite large. However, the domestic inputs used or the yield is comparatively less. The most prominently cultivated crops would be wheat and maize. In prairies, wheat, cotton and maize are largely cultivated. The wheat cultivated in this region is not meant for human consumption. They are fed to the cattle for their fattening before the slaughter. Coming to the steppe region, steppe is called as the wheat bowl of the earth. This is because wheat is largely cultivated in this region. The soil here is black soil, but it is different from that of the black soil in Deccan Plateau of our country. The soil is black in the Deccan Plateau, that is mostly due to the volcanic activities, the volcanic ashes, residue, lava and other leftovers. Whereas the black soil in steppe happens because of a unique type of a rock found in this region. In tropical regions, sugar is mainly cultivated out of sugarcane. Sugar is extracted out of sugarcane. Whereas in steppe, sugar is produced from sugar beet. In pampas, animal husbandry and livestock rearing are the most important economic activities. Wheat is cultivated. In downs, sheep and cattle rearing are common, especially for wool. Australia is famous for wool production. With that, we have come to an end of this video. Hope you found it informative. For more queries on anthropology or courses available in Sourcing Classes, log on to www.sourcingclasses.com. Thus, animal husbandry and livestock rearing are the most important economic activities. Wheat is cultivated. In downs, sheep and cattle rearing are common, especially for wool. Australia is famous for wool production. With that, we have come to an end of this video. Hope you found it informative. For more queries on anthropology or courses available in Sourcing Classes, log on to www.sourcingclasses.com.